Well, welcome back to the Steve Robb Show. Today, we're going to talk about block heaters. Yeah, the ones you got in your truck or your car. If you live in a cold climate, you're using them. Well, I hope you are. But today, I'm going to show you a couple of things. This is what I use. This is one of my meters. This is another meter I got, just a cheap meter. Guys, this is the cheapest meter I got, and it works fine for this too. I'll just open it up here for you. It's a small little compact job, and I like it. This is it right here. And for automotive use, it's completely fine for me, just for testing batteries and just 12 volt circuits and that. This one here, I wouldn't plug that into my mains in a million years. The Fluke, I would trust. And this little gizmo here today, this one right here. Now this one here, when you plug it into any 120 volt circuit, it'll tell you what your wattage is, it'll tell you what your amperage is, and your voltage. And that's very important. So what does this have to do with block heaters? Well, buddy of mine asked me to come over and take a look at his truck. He's got the same truck, but a newer one. I've got a 2002 Silverado. He's got a 2007. So he plugged his block heater in, and nothing was happening. Usually you can hear the crackle of when it starts up. And sometimes you can, sometimes you can't, depending on what kind of block heater you have. But he wasn't getting nothing out of it. So I told him, I said, best thing for you to do is get your own meter out and put it across two spades. I got a cord here. Let me just take a look. Yeah, I got a cord here. And you just go across your two sides here. And you can take an ohm reading. Like take, for instance, on my Silverado. That's a 400 watt block heater. So it draws around 3 amps, maybe 36 ohms. My Ford is a 600 watt, and of course I checked it with this, is a 600 watt, and it draws around 5 amps, maybe 25 ohms, something around there. And another friend of mine, he's got a Duramax diesel, and his is 1,000 watts. Like, that's pretty big. So that was down to around 13, 14 ohms, maybe 8, 9 amps. Now, When you're looking at your plug, this is what you got here hanging out the front of your truck. And he goes to plug it in, and nothing's happening. So I go over to his house, and I plug it in, and same as he did. And I looked at his plug, and I said, what are you plugged into here, buddy? And so he showed me the outlet, and the outlet was blown. The breaker was gone. So I says, either you got a bad breaker or you got something wrong with your truck. And guys, what he had was some animal, a squirrel or a mouse, I'm not too sure what, had gone in there and chewed the wires, so it was a direct short. Now the best thing that you can do, and I'll show you today, is how to check your block heater. And a lot of people don't actually think about testing first before they plug something in. They usually wait until it blows a fuse or does something. But a lot of times, especially with automotive, yeah, there's a lot of animals underneath the hoods and a lot of vehicles, and they're chewing on wires and everything else. And this is the only time you're going to have on a vehicle 120 volts, except a hybrid or something. But yeah, it's good to check this. So let's go out to the truck and we'll check the cord, and you'll see how Ohm's law works. Okay, there we are right there. Now let's take a look at each one of these pieces of equipment and we'll try it out on the block heater plug. And first of all, guys, make sure your plug is clean. A lot of times, you know, people just have it thrown in their front of their grill and it gets quite dirty. It's good just to wire brush it and clean it all up. So there it is right there, guys. I'll just bring the screen up a bit for you if I can zoom in. There you go. That's not too bad there. So that's all within range. And guys, let's try the cheapy meter out. You don't gotta spend a lot of money on a meter to get a half decent reading. I don't know if you can see that or not, guys, but that's 34.1, and that's not bad at all. So I mean, there you go. You don't gotta spend a fortune on a meter. It works fine for this type of stuff. Okay, guys, there we are right there. I got her plugged in. and you're seeing 118 volts. Let's go to the next mode. 3.41 amps. And there we are there, guys. It's going between 398. So 398, 397, and that's the wattage. So this is just a terrific little item to have so you can actually measure. Okay, so I imagine you're wondering, like, what kind of a reading am I gonna get if I have a shorted block heater cable? Well, you just imagine just getting a piece of wire like this and just crossing it out. Guys, that's how low of a reading you're gonna get. You're obviously gonna notice that there's something definitely wrong. If you take a look at any Ohm's law chart and you put in, you know, the wattage of your block heater, you know, like 400 watts, well, it'll show you exactly what you can expect to see as a Ohm's resistance. And if you're not seeing that, there's obviously something wrong. And a lot of people over the years have had a, you know, a bad burnt out wire or the connection going into the block heater itself, and you're just not going to get the right, you know, the right reading. So it's good to test first, because in this particular situation, if my friend would have checked with his meter first, he would have noticed right off the bat that it was a short. So I think that's a good thing to do. And guys, this little cheapy meter here, guys, this is really cheap. This is a cheapy meter. And all these cheapy meters, I always tell everybody, do not ever plug these into your mains. Guys, these are under $20. Both of my cheapy meters are under $20. I think the Fluke is like 140 bucks or something. But I carry with this all the time. I have it in the truck. And sometimes if you have to take a reading, you know, it's easy, and it's, you know, it's not going to be that far out. Not for how close you got to be. I mean, we're not testing, you know, space modules here or anything. So, yeah, so I hope you like that. And if you haven't seen this channel before, you're welcome to subscribe and see some more of this testing stuff going on in the future. Thanks for joining in here today, and check your block heater. Cheers, guys.